sir, you have one of the wide experience in cardiological therapeutic area, and you have gone through the various kind of the stroke management patients in atrial fibrillation, from the oral anticoagulants, newer one, older one, then the antiplatelets, and now the newer generation. So step by step, you have seen the improvements and also the advantages and disadvantages of this group of the molecules. So what your final take on this particular group of the molecules, that it can improve the stroke condition, prevention the stroke condition in AFib?
As you rightly said, that it is one of the commonest arrhythmias, and its incidence goes on increasing with increasing age. And besides other things that you have rightly pointed out, the stroke is one of the biggest threat, or almost 4 to 5 times as compared to normal individual or so. Newer anticoagulants have made a sort of a very major breakthrough. Now, you cannot say which is good, which is bad, which is all this. See, there are two things. I will say the problem with the newer anticoagulants is their cost. In a country like India, say if the a medicine is very costly, it produces a less compliance on the part of patient.
Yes.
Because it has to go throughout the life of the patient, and if it is very costly, then of course it creates a problem. However, they are very effective, so it is a sort of a double-edged weapon.
Yes.
And although antidotes to these drugs are being developed, but I think they are not freely available in India.
No.
That is one problem. And the vitamin K antagonist there of course it is very commonly available. So various head-to-head comparison has been done, and they have got advantages, disadvantages. For example, dabigatran, they get more of a gastrointestinal bleedings,
yes,
less of an intracranial bleeds also. It has to be given twice a day.
Yes.
Other drugs are given once a day, and their gastric irritation is less in these situations. So there are definitely a lot of head-to-head trials are being done and should be done to see as to which one is good. But I would say that these newer ones, they have created a really good revolution in the prevention of an atrial fibrillation. Because we have to find out the seriousness, how much a person is prone to it. By the same CHADS VAS score is very important. We grade the patient, and the higher the score, the poorer is the outlook. So we have to be very cautious in these patients. Then only thing we have to see is, besides cost, we have to see the any history of any chronic dyspepsia, any renal impairment or so.
Okay.
So I would say, if my personal take is that these drugs will gradually take over the older drugs also, provided this cost factor is considered and a very rapidly available antidote is available. So they will definitely take over. We have used dabigatran and all the and other drugs also, and there, let us see how it goes on.
Definitely. So this is a very well said, and it's a very crisp. There is entire information regarding the newer generation of oral anticoagulants. They have the advantage against the older one regarding the INR monitoring and better efficacy, even safety as well.
Yes.
Safety is a major beauty of this particular NOAC as compared to the vitamin K antagonist. But provided the cost is a factor which can lead to a longer term of the adherence with this particular kind of the treatment.
Yes.
So this is a challenging factor, and along with that also an antidote.
Because
freely available, and it should be available because the dabigatran is antidote is already approved in US FDA,
yeah,
and the rest of the rivaroxaban, apixaban, the antidote is going on. So very soon it should be there in India, but it's a matter of future. But as of now, it's not available in India.
That is one of the limiting factors which is coming, because we don't know what to do.
Yeah, what to do in this situation?
Yes.
Happen with this kind of the drugs. So it's a very short and it's a very practical approach that's regarding the NOAC and stroke prevention atrial fibrillation. So I think with this note we are ending our discussion. So thanks a lot, Dr. Parashar, and for your all the valuable comments and your
thanks very much. And I can assure you that these drugs are going to take over in future.
Sure. Thanks a lot.
Thank you very much.